Singer Amy Winehouse will be laid to rest at a private ceremony attended by her family and close friends later today. A post-mortem on the singer has failed to find an actual cause of death, as her parents thanked fans camped outside her North London home where she died.
Amy Winehouse's last journey through London was a decidedly modest affair. Her body was driven from the coroner's court this afternoon, where an inquest heard her death wasn't suspicious, but the cause is still unknown. Earlier, her father Mitch and mother Janice visited her home, where piles of flowers and tributes have been building all day. Reading messages, the emotion clearly too much. And then, to a dignified calm, he spoke to her fans.
I can't tell you what this means to us. It really is making this a lot easier for us. You know, Amy was about one thing, and that was love. A whole life was devoted to her family and her friends, and to you guys as well. So we're devastated and I'm speechless.
Mitch Winehouse had fought to keep Amy off the drink and drugs that were to ruin her. He moved in with her, threatened to have her sectioned, and pleaded with her through the media. But it was the love of another man that was to cause her so much pain. A self-confessed drug user, Blake Fielder Civil, has in the past been blamed for her demise, something her ex-husband's own mother admits today.
Yes, I think he has to take his portion of blame. He has. I can't say whether or not Amy did drugs prior to meeting Blake. I can't. I think that's something that nobody will ever really know. But yes, in my heart, I think Blake has to take a portion of blame.
Well, tributes are still pouring in tonight. The mound of flowers is growing rapidly. It's perhaps a measure of the love that Amy Winehouse garnered around the world, and perhaps a measure of the love she will continue to garner after her death.